Hello friends, welcome back to 2020 as well as welcome back to Best Way to Study. First of all, wish you all a very happy new year and very happy and prosperous new year. And in 2019, we just hit 10,000 subscribers. That is all because of you. Thank you so much for supporting me so far. So in this video, we are going to discuss all the details about SBI SO notification, which is going to be released in few days. So coming to SBI SO, SO stands for Specialist Officer. SBI is going to release the notification of FO in January, first week of 2020. That is within few days, we are going to have the notification, official notification from the SBI. And coming to this particular exam, it is going to be conducted in February of 2020. Yes, we have very few days left to prepare and to crack the exam. We should use every minute and every day of this month, because exam is going to be conducted in February itself. And coming to the application forms are going to be released in third week of January 2020, and they are going to close by 31st January 2020. Yes, you heard it right. Third week applications will be released, and by fourth week applications are going to get closed. So we should be very fast for applying for this exam, because as the days of application is very few, the people will be applying and the site will be busy. So be very quick in order to apply for SBI exam, SBI SO exam. And coming to few other details, last date of exam fees is fourth week of January. Like after fourth week of January, application fees are not accepted. Okay, so you can get your hall ticket or admit card by second week of February 2020, and exam will be in the third week, and results are going to be declared by second or third week of March 2020. Yes, you got all the information. Now let's see what is the eligibility criteria and what are the preparation tips and few more. Okay, so coming to the eligibility criteria, you should be in between 21 to 35 years. Like you should not be, your age should not be less than 21. Your age should not be more than 35. The age limit is 21 to 35 years. Okay. If you are in this limit of age, like your age is in between 21 to 35, you can happily apply for this exam because you are eligible for it. Okay. So if you are having reservation, if you are of a reservation category, you will have age relaxation up to 2 years. Okay, so now let's see what are the educational qualifications and what are the departments and what are the roles available for this particular exam. Okay, so coming to the department, if you wanted to be in the department of Deputy General Manager, then your age should be 42 years to 52 years. Okay, in order to apply this exam, the age limit is fixed. It is 21 to your age should be in between 21 to 35. But if you want to apply for these particular roles, you have different age limit. Okay, so if you wanted to be in the department of Deputy General Manager, your age can be between 42 to 52. Okay, and your qualification must be degree. It must be degree. It may be of 3 years degree or 5 years degree, but you must have a degree certificate and you should complete your degree. Okay, so coming to the experience, you should be at least 17 years experienced. Like you should at least have 17 years of experience in order to apply for this particular role. Okay, and next is, in order to apply for Specialist Management Executive, your age should be in between 30 to 40 years, and your educational qualification is, you should either be CA or CS or ICWA. Okay, you can either be CA, CS or ICWA. ICWA, and your experience should be minimum of at least 5 years. Okay, so coming to deputy manager, your age should be 25 to 35 years, and you must have a degree, and you should have at least 4 years of experience. Okay, so coming to deputy general manager under section law, under law, you should have at least 42 to 52 years, and you should also have experience of more than 15 years. Okay, so coming to the application fees, if you are general category or OBC, your fees will be 600 rupees. If you are ST, SC or any other category, your fees is going to be 100 rupees. Okay, and coming to the exam pattern, which is one of the most important thing, it is an online exam. Okay, it is not offline exam, it is an online exam. You have to go to the exam center and give a computer based test. It is completely an online exam. Okay, so coming to this particular written test, that is coming to this particular online exam, you are going to have four different sections in the exam. First section is going to be in reasoning, second section is English, third is professional knowledge, fourth is quantitative aptitude. Okay, so coming to this particular four different sections, what you need to do is let's see what are the questions, like how many questions will be appeared in the exam and how many marks, what is the time limit, all those details, let's see. So coming to reasoning, 50 questions will be asked and marks will be 50. So one correct question, 1 mark for you. Okay, so coming to quantitative aptitude, there will be 35 questions and 35 marks. Coming to English, you'll be having 35 questions and 35 marks as well. Okay, so coming to the professional language, you are going to have 50 questions and you're going to have 100 marks for these 50 questions. It means in professional language, each correct question will be giving you 2 marks, where 50 questions gives you 100 marks, and the time limit for professional language is 45 minutes, and time limit of reasoning, aptitude, and English is together 90 minutes. Okay, so now let's see what is the syllabus. Coming to the reasoning, the syllabus is, coming to reasoning, your syllabus is going to contain classification, clocks and calendars, arguments, and also directions, coding and decoding, puzzle test, analogy, alphanumeric puzzles, data sufficiency, what are the missing numbers, series, arithmetic reasoning, and also conclusions for the passages, and also eligibility test, logical sequence of the words, time sequence, ranking sequence. So this is the syllabus particularly for reasoning. Okay, and coming to this particular syllabus, I'm going to give you important topics as well, which are very important are clocks and calendars, alphabetic test, alphanumeric series, and sequence puzzles, data sufficiency, mathematical operations, arithmetic reasoning, time sequence, series completion. These are very, very important. Also, logical Venn diagrams are also very important. So, coming to English, let's see the syllabus and then I'll tell what are the important topics. First, let's see the syllabus. Coming to English, synonyms, clause test, antonyms, vocabulary, comprehension, verbs, conclusions, word phrases, word formations, grammar, sentence rearrangement, sentence completion, subject verb agreement, idioms, phrases, sentence correction, and also fill in the blanks, theme detection, error correction. So these are the topics, and also passage correction. These are the topics which are under syllabus of English. And coming to English, what are the most important topics are comprehension, clause test, synonyms, sentence rearrangement, and sentence correction, as well as sentence completion, idioms and tenses. Okay, so let's see a few more details about the cutoff. Okay, so coming to the cutoff, cutoff will be basically depending upon the exam paper difficulty. If the difficulty, like if the exam is very tough, then cutoff comes down. If the paper is very easy, then there's a possibility of increasing of the cutoff. So right now they didn't officially announce any cutoff. So basically, if you see the cutoff of last year, it might be resembling. So it will be like mostly related to the last year cutoff only. So that's it for today. Once there is official notification for this exam, I'll surely make another video. And there are many bank exams as well as government exams upcoming for 2020. So if you want to get more details and if you want me to give you explanation of all these topics of reasoning, aptitude and everything, what you need to do is don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also don't forget to hit the bell icon which is beside the subscribe button, and also don't forget to like this video and do share this video with all your friends. And if you have any queries or any doubts related to this video or this exam, do let me know in the comment section below. And please subscribe and share this video. Please hit the notification bell icon as well, because I am making videos just for you people. So all the very best for this exam. Start preparing. I've given you all the details, all the exam syllabus also. So what are you waiting for? Just go and start your preparation. All the best. Hope you crack this exam. And if you have any doubts, queries, let me know in the comment section below. So see you in my next video. Thanks for watching.